Hello friends, how are you all doing? I hope you all are fine and healthy. Today I have brought you a very healthy recipe of palak paneer, that is spinach with cottage cheese. Spinach is full of iron, magnesium, calcium, and paneer is full of again calcium and protein. So it is a very good recipe for your weight loss. It has less calories and very nutritious and helps in you in getting full by eating less. No matter how much spinach you will eat, you will not get so much calories. So that is why it is very good recipe if you are on a weight loss journey. Anyhow, even if you are not intent to weight loss, it is a very healthy recipe. Before moving on to the recipe, please subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it already. I post all the healthy recipes which are quick and easy to cook. And I will be also sharing with you a glimpse of my journey in Germany. How is my lifestyle in Germany? So let's move to the recipe. So for this recipe, naturally we need spinach. I have taken 800 grams of frozen spinach. You can also take fresh spinach and boil it for 2 to 3 minutes in warm water. Not more than that, otherwise spinach will get bitter in taste. And then you can let it cool. I have taken frozen spinach and I took it out from my refrigerator around 5 to 6 hours ago. And then I put it in the microwave for 10-15 minutes and made it a little bit in liquid and thawed it. Then I have taken onions, 2 big onions. Roughly chopped, you don't have to cut it finely because later on we will be doing it in a grinder. Ginger, you can add as much ginger as you want because with spinach, ginger tastes really good. I have taken around 2 inches of ginger piece. I have taken 2 cloves of garlic. Some cumin seeds you can take, or I have taken panchpuran. Panchpuran is a combination of 5 types of seeds: fennel seeds, mustard seeds, fenugreek seeds, and nigella seeds. I will be using some kasuri methi, it is fenugreek leaves. They will give a very good aroma to the dish. I am taking also 1/2 cup of cashews. If you want to avoid the calories, you can skip the cashew part, because cashews increase the calorie content, but cashews are also full of health and full of potassium, so take it if you want to. And some around 500 grams of paneer I am taking, some butter to fry, and some cheese I will be adding for the garnishing, and some tomato puree. The paneer, I made it myself. I showed you my previous recipe. I will give you the link how to make paneer at home in my description box. So the way which I use, which was left over from making paneer, I will be using in this recipe to make palak paneer. So in a pan, I'm melting some butter. I will add some cumin seeds or panchpuran, whatever you want, into it and let it saute. This recipe is very quick to make. We think it is very complicated, it is very fancy. It looks fancy, but it is still so quick to make. So when your seed starts to splutter, then one by one I will add garlic, ginger, and onion. And saute them well. You can cut chopped tomatoes, but right now I have tomato puree, so I will be adding that. So when onion starts to change a little bit color, then you can also add cashews and let them also get a little bit brown, saute them. Cashews is very creamy texture to the recipe, Instead of cashews, you can also actually add yogurt. So look, now cashews are roasted. You don't have to change the color of onion so much. I will add tomatoes at this stage. I have taken around 2 tomato purees. That is the thing about Indian cuisine, that smell, that sound of spluttering the seeds. It's really very good and aromatic. So at this stage, I will add also this kasuri methi, fenugreek leaf. They also tend to give a very good aroma to the recipe, and they are very, very healthy for your blood. They purify the blood and also give it a taste like your restaurant. It is easily available in Indian shops, dried fenugreek leaves. So now the masala is roasted very well. All the water is evaporated. So I will turn off the heat and I will let it cool down. And then I will put it in a blender and grind it. You don't have to put the hot mixture into the blender. It will not work. It will actually cause injuries. So don't do it. When the mixture is properly cooled down, only then put it in the blender. So now the mixture was cool. I grinded it in this blender. And I have taken the same pan. You can take a different pan if you want. And in this pan, you will again heat up the mixture. Look, the gravy is very thick and rich because of the cashews. You have to do it in a medium heat. And I will again warm up the mixture, clean up this mixture from the blender and add to it. And in the meantime, in the same blender, I will also make the puree of spinach. So in this gravy, if you add just paneer, it will become your butter paneer masala. If you add peas to it, it will become your matar paneer masala. And if you add more cream to it, it will become shahi paneer masala, like that. So with the same gravy, you can make so many recipes. So at this point, I will add heat. You have to keep it on medium to high flame. And I will be adding 1/2 teaspoon of turmeric, 1/2 teaspoon of black pepper, a little bit of chili. You can also add green chili, but I don't have green chili, so I will be adding a little bit of red chili. And salt to taste. I have taken 2 tablespoons of salt according to my taste. And then mix in this well. Kasuri methi is really giving it a very good aroma. So masala was already cooked, so it will not take much time. As it gives a little bit of boil, I will add pureed spinach to it. And mix it well. So after cooking for 2-3 minutes, when spinach starts boiling, we will add our paneer. You can also add white paneer, or you can fry paneer a little bit in a little bit of oil before adding to it. But after adding paneer, you don't have to cook it much, because otherwise paneer will get very tight and chewy. So just after 1 minute or so, we will turn off the heat. So for garnishing, I will be adding some cheese to it. It will give you some more cheesy flavor. You can add grated this cottage cheese, but I had some extra pizza cheese left, so I will also be adding this. then I have cut some julienne of ginger. They also taste very good with spinach. Spinach and ginger really taste very well. When I was shooting the recipe, I forgot to shoot that I also added some garam masala to it. If you want, don't want to have add garam masala, you can also add just coriander powder. It tastes very good with the spinach. If you like the recipe, please hit the like button, share it with your family and friends, and also subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it already. Please write to me in the comment box what are your suggestions, what you want to see on my vlogs, and I will see you in my next video. Till then, take very good care of yourself, stay happy, stay healthy, and stay blessed. Bye bye.